Item number, SCP-128. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-128 is to be held in a windowless containment chamber with blast-proof doors and walls, and a ventilation system that maintains Class 100 cleanroom conditions inside. The interior of the containment chamber is to be monitored remotely by cameras welded in place with protective grating. The speakers and laser monitoring system must be similarly welded into place and protected with grating. The entry to SCP-128's containment chamber must include an antechamber with a second locked door that cannot be viewed from the chamber door. Personnel entering the test chamber for any reason must wear ballistic armor and must not bring any loose item inside the chamber. All required equipment must be rigidly mounted to the armor. Interference with the laser monitoring system or the central wheel is forbidden, unless required for maintenance. In the center of the containment chamber, a wheel must be mounted to a concrete pedestal and allowed to spin freely. Should the wheel be measured to spin at less than 4,000 RPM at any time, all personnel are required to evacuate the containment chamber, and foam nozzles will be deployed. Description: SCP-128 is an immaterial source of kinetic energy, which can be conferred upon any non-living solid material within line of sight of the source. The source itself is modal, with a tendency to remain along the walls or at the central wheel of the containment chamber. The line of sight is blocked by any opaque material, including lead, steel, or even single sheets of paper, but not transparent materials, such as ballistic glass. Opaque radiolucent materials will contain SCP-128's range of effect, suggesting that transmission of energy occurs at visible light wavelengths, but darkness does not prevent transmission of kinetic energy. Any loose non-living materials within line of sight of SCP-128 are at risk of anomalous propulsion to hazardous velocities. Items under 100 grams in mass have been observed to accelerate to velocities of up to 900 meters per second in a period of 0.1 second, similar in force to machine gun fire. Analysis of the mass and velocity of every object undergoing acceleration indicates that the system of affected objects contains a constant linear momentum of 2,500 kilograms a meter per second, anomalously unconstrained by direction. It is therefore advisable to have many heavier items available to the object instead of fewer, lighter items. Despite SCP-128's invisible immaterial form, it has been determined that the entity cannot be compressed into a space under a 2-centimeter radius sphere. Such compression with opaque materials, however, is not advised, as dust particles within the space will be excited, generating extreme heat, potentially rupturing the compression container explosively. SCP-128 arbitrarily chooses which items to accelerate, with a slight statistical preference for new objects over older ones. Despite the existence of some form of acceleration choosing, tests do not indicate an active sentience directing the choice, with one exception. The object does not accelerate living material, with its own parameters regarding what is considered living. People or robots moving of their own accord are not accelerated, nor is any part that is rigidly attached. Dead or unconscious people and animals are also not accelerated. Unmoving but conscious test subjects report a light tugging in the presence of SCP-128, which immediately stops at the first sign of movement or animal-like characteristics. Plants and fungi, alive or dead, are similarly not accelerated. Unpowered robots, however, are susceptible to acceleration. Addendum 128-1, Recovery Log. SCP-128 was recovered from a private home and reports of telekinesis and random anomalous kinetic activity had been previously confirmed by field agents. An MTF Mu-13, Ghostbusters, was called in to isolate and capture the anomaly. Control. Okay, equipment check. Tranquilizer pistols? Mu-13 lead. All pistols loaded and checked. Control. Ballistic armor. Lead. Armor check. Mu-13 Gamma. I'm not used to carrying this ordnance. Control. It's standard issue for this sort of intangible. We had to dig deep in our files. Had to look up old references. SOP on this dates back to 1968. The phenomenon was called a poltergeist back then. Delta. Poltergeist. That is old. Type 1 or 2? Control. It could be a Type 1, a telekinetic vector associated with a deceased person, but field agents said that there's considerable domestic strife in the home. It's most likely undifferentiated kinetic energy from a latent Bixby under extreme stress. Type 2. Lead. That's why containment involves the pistols. Trank all inhabitants, and it should shut down the anomaly long enough for us to figure out whose astral it is. The standard EMP tools are for containment of an autonomous intangible, should it be Type 1. Careful in there. Take no chances. Beta, get the parabolic microphone on the house. We need to identify inhabitants. Beta, mic online now. POI 1, how many times do I have to tell you, Brittany, clean your f***ing room already? You're such a slob. POI 2, I did. It was spotless before I went to school. It was. Oh my god, Tyler, it was you, wasn't it, you little douche? POI 3, nuh-uh. Why would I want to step foot in your nasty ass pigsty? Gamma, considerable domestic strife, you say? Lead, yeah, just get in there and put them all to sleep. They could use the nap. And be careful with loose objects. Confirming 3 targets. Move out. Sounds of leaving the containment vehicle, approaching the house, and bashing in the door. Sound of tranquilizer pistol being fired. Delta, the sun's down. Lead, he looks young. Beta, check his vitals. Make sure the drugs aren't too much of a shock to his system. The darts are calibrated to someone at least 40 kilos. Gamma, Delta, find the father and daughter now. Footsteps through the house. Sound of tranquilizer pistol. Gamma, father's down. Reaching for a shotgun. Glad we got to him first. Lead, good work, Gamma. Delta, find the daughter. Delta, tracked her to her bedroom. There's stuff everywhere here, like a tornado ripped through here. Shades are pulled. She's got a pet hamster, but I don't see her. Trying the closet. Lead, careful, Delta. That's probably the source of the poltergeist activity. Delta, roger that. I just got hit in the face with a pillow. Lead, quick, Gamma, Delta needs backup. Screams heard. Sound of wood splintering. Sound of tranquilizer pistol firing. Delta, daughter is down. Repeat, daughter is down. Chair just got thrown against the wall. Bookshelf falling over. Activity increasing. Marbles! She has marbles! Ow! Lead, we got a Type 1. Get out of the room, Delta. Damn it, just ow! Everybody out! Delta, grab my hand and pull. Wait. It's the hamster. It's a f***ing tornado hamster. Tracking the hamster. Lead, Delta, no! The darts aren't calibrated! Sound of tranquilizer pistol firing. Delta, hamster down. Why aren't you stopping? I tranked your... Sound of data expunge. Lead, everybody out. Delta down. Close the doors. Get ready for Type 1 containment. End log. Closing notes. EMP deployment for Type 1 poltergeist containment functioned as expected, but failed to contain the anomaly. Move 13 Gamma back to the MTF truck through the residence wall into the daughter's bedroom, and opened the back doors. When the anomaly was observed to be inside the truck, the doors were shut, and backup was called to tow the truck with accelerated debris in the armored trailer. Cover story of tornado striking the house was released. Addendum 128-2. Principal Researcher's Notes. Principal Researcher, Dr. Cordelia Argent. Subject, SCP-128. Despite what the recovery log would say, this is not a poltergeist. Poltergeists are an obsolete term anyway. This is not a spirit or a consciousness as we might think of the term. It can't pass through walls or the like. This is a source of kinetic energy. I've updated the description to show this. It's hard to say what precisely it is, but it appears to be best thought of as a whole, through which a constant momentum enters this universe. How this is accomplished is still the subject of further tests. In addition, the hamster did not have direct control over the phenomenon. If the hamster had conscious control, then the phenomenon would have ceased with its termination. Instead, if we continue the analogy of this being a hole, then the hamster was a valve covering the hole, which could have been opened or closed to allow in more or less momentum. This valve appears to have been stuck open. So all the talk about us having the ghost of a telekinetic hamster in containment should stop. It's inaccurate. Scratch notes only. Please delete. Dr. C. Argent. C. Argent. Hi, Rod. Are you there? R. Argent. Hi, Cordy. Yes, I am. Congrats on your promotion. How are things? C. Argent. Okay. But I've been put in charge of 128, and its containment is stressing me out. R. Argent. What's that? Can you send me the file? C. Argent. Yeah, hold on. Sending SCP-128.SCP. R. Argent. Got it. So it's some kind of kinetic energy entity? Sounds like just your sort of thing, Dr. Anomalous Physics. C. Argent. Ha ha, very funny. Yes, I figured out it's a field of constant momentum without a center of mass. Essentially, you treat the momentum of the system as a scalar constant instead of a vector, independent of direction. Simple enough mathematically, but it does mean that the energy in the kinetic system is constantly fluctuating and being added to maintain the constant scalar momentum. It's supposed to be modulated up and down, but apparently it was under control of a hamster, and when the hamster died, the field got stuck at up. R. Argent. So what's the issue about containment? There are procedures here. C. Argent. They're ridiculous. It's basically give it toys but take them away whenever someone enters the chamber just so it can fire the researcher's clipboard through his skull. I've had to fill the room with foam pillows and send janitorial D-class in there in full battle armor just to clear the body away. The site director says that's not the first time, and I just... What am I supposed to do? R. Argent. You need a constant linear momentum without center of mass vector positioning in the containment chamber. And the controller entity of the momentum field demonstrates some familiarity with objects. C. Argent. Yes. R. Argent. It's a hamster. Give it a wheel. C. Argent. It's not a ham... That's why you're the biologist and I'm the physicist. Thank you. R. Argent. You're still the smart one with the promotion, sis. You're welcome. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-127, The Living Gun, right now. Or, for the complete course, watch this playlist.